everyone, this is Ronnie once again of Coffee Moments with Ronnie. For the celebration of Mother's Day, I invited one special guest. I consider her as my academic mother. She's one of my academic mothers when I was studying in Technological University of the Philippines. So she supported me. Actually, she's the one who helped me to acquire the scholarship. So she helped me so much, honestly, to survive my college days. And up to now, I consider her, I so much thankful and grateful for accepting this invitation, because for the special month, actually, Mother's Day should be every day, but I consider this episode for the preparation for Mother's Day. So, ladies and gentlemen, my special guest, Dr. Mother Marie Cruz. Ma'am.
Thank you so much, Ronnie. Thank you so much for the kind words that you have for me earlier. And of course, it's always an honor to be considered to be part of your coffee talks, your simple talks, really feels good for me to be part of this. Thank you. Thank you, Ronnie. Thank you.
Of course, it is a privilege, especially on my part, to for you to accept this invitation. First of all, normally I ask my guests the story behind their name. Even though your name is not quite common, my real name actually may story. So, ma'am, could you share to everyone ano ba yung story behind, if your parents told you about that, ano yung story behind the name Marie, Rosemarie, name nyo talaga. So, ano po ba ang pinaka short story nito, ma'am?
Okay, actually, that was also my question to my mom. Because when I was having, siyempre, to write my name Rosemarie, parang pag Rosemarie, may certain connotation siya. So, I was also curious on my part. So, I asked her. I remember I was only 7 years old, to recall back, no? I asked her, why did you give me the name Rosemarie? Although at the time I was only using the word the name Rosemarie, okay. The Theresa only came on later on nung nag-check na yung birth certificate, okay. But anyway, Rosemarie lang talaga yung ginagamit ko sa nung school age ko, no. So I asked my mom, and she told me that at the time the famous actress was Rosemarie Sonora. Okay.
All right.
And, yeah, usually parents would have to be naming the name, having the names of famous actors and actresses for their children. So I got the name Rosemarie. So, and later on, of course, the Theresa came into the picture now, because I cannot already get rid of the Theresa because it's already my real name. So it's because usually for Catholics, naman, we would always have to refer to the calendar. Right, and series would have to be also celebrating, okay, on October. Okay, so I was named with the Teresa, or given the name Teresa.
So Saint Teresa from the Saint Teresa.
Right, Saint Teresa, yes, but Teresa naman yung sa akin. So Rosemarie Teresa, and actually secret pa niyan, the Teresa that I had before was not even with an H. Kasi sa iba yung sa name ko sa baptismal. As sa birth, but syempre, you need to have it fixed, no? So what's in the birth certificate
should be followed.
Recognized, okay. So usually when I would have to be spelling out my name, it would be, okay, so it's Rosemarie, okay, one word, and then Teresa with an H.
Ano yung kinoconsider yung pinaka-nickname? Since normally kasi sa bahay, pagka ganit yung magulang, tinatawag tayo ng pangalan ng buo.
My nickname is Marie. So yun yung endearment, no, na Marina tinatawag ako ng parents ko. No? Although my dad would have to call me darling. Okay. But yung darling minsan-minsan lang din yun. Pero syempre pag yung mga sweet moments, but I was used to really being called Marie using Marie as my nickname. So wala naman na bago even with my colleagues, okay? I would have to be Marie, okay? So sweet sound.
Kayo po ba yung namili niyan, o yung parents niyo na initiate na tawagin kayong Marie?
No, I did not choose it, but it just came, no? Kasi nung tinatawag nila akong Marie, so pag tinatanong nila ako ngayon, di ba? So what's your nickname? So when you would have to introduce yourself, when you were young, di ba? So I would have to say, my nickname is Marie, kasi yun na yung ano, yun na yung na-build sa akin.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much for sharing that story. Ma'am, yes. Saan po ba kayo lumaki, ma'am?
Practically, I grew up in the busy city of Manila, but I don't really have vivid recall of how I was then, no? But, so we transferred. So when my dad left, okay, so iniwan niya kami sa aunt ko.
Where in particular area in Manila that you grew up?
I know we live in Paco. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Somewhere in Paco. Pero hindi ko na rin maalala kung saan yun. Pero parang pag minsan pag dumadaan kami ng Paco.
Opo.
But I grew up mga 7 years old kasi alam ko lumipat na kami sa Quezon City. Okay. But even in Paco and in Quezon City, nasa home lang ako. Okay. I would just be watching children from the outside. Especially that I'm the only child too. So, wala talaga akong interaction. So, yung mga kasama lang sa bahay. Okay.
Now, nung sabi nyo nga, homebody kayo at the same time, nag-iisa nga na anak. So, nung high school kayo, so, number one, kasi babae pa. Paano kayo minomodo? Ano yung pinupus sa inyo ng parents nyo na anong particular course ang nababagay sa inyo? Kasi normally, parents muna or ating relatives or family is the one who influence us what particular course that we are going to take in college.
Yeah. With that, I'm very thankful and blessed that both my mom and dad gave me the freedom of choosing. Wala sila for as long, although syempre they were trying to give in their feeds, diba, right? You have to take accounting course, you have to take this course, okay? So they were just suggesting, but there was no pressure on my part, okay? Although they had some reservations also, because at the time psychology was not just sounding good to them, no? Diba, usually parents would have to, that they would have to be giving us courses that would make money.
And also popular.
And popular courses. So, but I'm really thankful and blessed that even if my decision is not going with what they have in mind, no?
So, pero ma'am, alam niyo yung gusto nila na kuhain yung course?
Kasi my dad is a frustrated lawyer. So sana gusto niya, okay, yung mga pre-law and then eventually, usually mga typical commerce, no? Pero sabi ko, I could not be good in commerce because I'm really not good in numbers.
Mom, sabi nyo kanina napili nyo agad yung psychology. Who influenced you o sino yung nagbigay sa inyo ng idea na about this course?
I was at an early age, I was already interested in human behavior. Probably because I was by myself, no? I was by myself. And I was really very much interested to look into this. And it so happened na yung my aunt was in the US, okay, is working as a psychologist. So hindi pa rin siya dun ganun kasound, no? But I was already hearing about psychology. Okay. So sabi ko, parang gusto ko to. And there was, I would remember also, and I'm always thankful to her. Okay, best friend ko siya nung high school. No? Best friend ko siya nung high school. She was also very much interested into behavior and everything. No? She introduced to me the book, Everything Talks to Me. Talagang determined na ako talaga na whatever it takes, okay, I would have to be in psychology.
Yes. Okay, ma'am. So since ito nga yung course na gusto nyong piliin, and how do you manage to choose the university?
Siyempre, the usual mode that a student would have to be looking forward would be which of these university are known for offering these courses, right? And again, because we had the means then, okay? So, naka-apply naman ako.
Opo.
So, lahat ng universities na in-applyan ko, I did not apply for any other course except for psychology.
Okay, ma'am. So, napunta na nga kayo sa UST, if I'm correct.
Yes.
Okay. So, nung nag-aral kayo sa UST, tapos gustong-gusto nyo talaga yung course na to, at yours, sabi nyo kasi, sarili nyo na mismo at during yung high school na nakabasa kayo ng notebook na lahat ng inquiries nyo or lahat ng question nyo about psychology, eto lalo na yung nag-push sa inyo. So it means na during your college days while taking the course psychology, hindi kayo nahirapan?
Well, hindi naman pwede yun, di ba? Parang wala naman atang madali lang na course, no? Talagang may mga pagdadaanan ka ng mga courses, no? But there are also light courses. But I would always have to have this thinking kasi na no matter how hard these subjects are, if you really like the course, you'll make a way, di ba? Kahit na dugudugan ka na. Kasi ang practically kasi dahil sa amin, pre-med course kami. So, correct, we cannot go with the other courses na talagang mahirap, no? Mahirap na memorization and a lot of things, no? Okay.
Is there an instant na nagkaroon kayo ng regret? Ba't ko ba kinuha tong course na to? Ba't ba ako nandirito? Is there an instance that happened to you?
Kasi wala akong ibang course in mind. Pero ano ako eh, parang ano ako noon, babayo na may tapalodo. Parang gano'n.
So yung focus nyo talaga nandun lang talaga sa psychology?
Sa psychology. Siguro kaya hindi ako nagkaroon ng regret, okay? Because I would have to take na, kasi I chose this, so whatever, kung ano man yung nandun doon sa curriculum na yon, then I have to totally embrace it. And of course, to pass it because I would like to graduate with a degree.
Alright. So, napakaganda ng motivation nyo. But ano naman yung pinaka-unforgettable experience nyo that time sa college while taking the course psychology?
Ah, yes, yes. This is actually, I would say, we're only a few. Only a few who would have this experience kasi meron kami talagang prof. Hi, Sir Buji. I'd like to acknowledge you now. We have one professor in psychology, major subject. He has really that this distinct style, no, for the recitation. Okay, he would have the bowling pin and the bell. Okay, so conditioning, pinag-aaralan na kami, ginagawa na kami subject. So the most unforgettable experience that I had is that I was really very lucky. Imagine for one semester, we're about 50 in the class, no? If I would remember it right, no? Mga 50 kami sa class or 40 plus and above, no? And ilan lang ba ang meetings? Ilan lang ba yon? Sa isang semestre, dalawang beses akong naging beauty queen. I would say that I was...
Oh, hindi namin to alam, mama. Hindi namin to alam.
No, not a beauty queen. I'm just having to translate it in a more, funny concept, okay? But at the time, it was really very traumatic, you know, how it was then. You can just put in to my shoe, okay? I-recreate ko yung scenario, no?
Scenario.
Every time that he would enter the classroom, he would already be turning over the bowling pin to the first row, okay? Tapos yung bowling pin na yun, habang nagdi-discussion ng lecture namin, which is neuroanatomy, imagine, neuroanatomy, okay? So, ngayon, habang nagdi-discuss siya, whoever holds the bowling pin at the time he pressed on the bell, okay, ikaw ang magdi-discuss for the rest of the class. Okay? You can just imagine from among the number of students that we have, bakit I was so lucky enough, okay, that within the semester, I had the bowling pin in my hand twice. Okay? Yung bowling pin na yun, talagang humahagis yun. Humahagis yun. Kaya lang, syempre, kahit nahihagis mo na, sa'yo pa rin. Sa'yo pa rin siya. So, now, before, it was really traumatic that every time, you know, we were actually preparing because you really have to go in front of the class. Okay? Ito na yun. So, lahat ng mga brain parts, oh my God. You know? But, you know, looking back, no, nakakatuwa, sabi ko dati, traumatic siya. Kasi, di ba, syempre, nung sa correct student mode ka, everything out of your comfort zone is really something for you to carry and to bear, right? And so, kailangan talaga prepared ka, okay? Kasi, syempre, iba yun pag nandun ka na sa harap. And that is really one thing that I enjoyed likewise. Mm-hmm. I have something to look back na hindi na-experience sa mga kaklase ko.
At pinagtatawanan nyo na lang.
Yeah, natatawa na lang kasi naaalala ko nang talagang natataranta talaga ako. Okay, natataranta ako. At saka, hindi naman kasi talaga ako ganito ka-vocal noon. You know, I was shy and the timid type na. Of course, with my friends, no? But it's different kung nasa classroom na. Okay. Ako yung typical student lang, natahimik lang dyan. Not unless it would be a graded recitation that you'd really have to be speaking up. Okay, kaya nagulat na po, nandito na ako sa teaching profession.
Okay. Ma'am, nung sabi nito, ito bang neuroanatomy yung naging favorite subject na?
hindi. Pwede na rin.
Pero ano talaga yung pinaka-favorite subject nyo nung nag-aaral kayo?
Actually, kasi nga dahil sa psychology, syempre ang focus ng psychology is more on testing, on therapy. Correct. So it's psychology. Of course, but you cannot go beyond or understand human behavior not unless you are aware or are acquainted with the physiological aspect. So, kailangan alam mo yon. So, kahit para alam mo kung bakit nangyayari yung mga ganun, mga experiences,
right?
So, physiologically explained. But just the same, of course, ano ko lang doon, I'm excited dahil nga alam mo that in the future as a psychology graduate, your career path would be more directed to HR or if ever you'll be into therapy. Never in my mind did I really thought about the academe.
Alright. So, pupunta tayo dyan later on. Okay. So, after you finish the course, paano nga na-manage na mag-land sa first job nyo?
Okay. My first two jobs are not actually applied jobs. They were assigned jobs. when my parents had to leave, okay, to migrate, okay, so my dad entrusted me to her friend. Okay, mm-hmm. I graduate ko lang noon. So he entrusted me to her friend into the travel agency. Okay, but after a while, so it's good then, no? I'm really thankful also for this simple, short time jobs that I have, no? But they were really helpful to me nung dito sa job ko na sa TUP. Okay? Kaya may idea na ako how it is to process visas and everything, no? Because of that, I was the liaison officer. But after several months, okay, again, sabi ko nga, required job na siya, no? My cousin Ninong, okay, who's having a law firm, okay, uh-huh, is in need of a secretary. So sabi niya, instead na iba yung natutulungan mo, kasi diba nandun doon, so wala pa naman kasi akong permanent job, no? So he actually asked me to be his legal secretary at the time. Okay. So parang April ako nag-start dun sa travel agency. April, no? Tapos tinawag niya na ako ng parang August dun sa legal. Kaya natuwa rin ako, ano na naman yung inputs ko dun sa legal secretary. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, I was acquainted with the different legal documents, templates, and how, di ba, syempre magta-type ka, so na-remember mo yon. So, kaya nga, required job sila. So, hindi ko siya nakikita still na professional job ko.
Okay? Pero ma'am, nung nasa travel agency kayo, when you first received the salary, ano yung naramdaman nyo na fulfilling ba yung sweldo ko sa pinag-aralan ko nung college? So, kahit hindi ko siya nagagamit, basta sumusweldo ako. Ganun ba yung naging setup niyo?
Yes, that's definitely. Para ito na pala talaga. Totoo na pala, nagtatrabaho na ako. Parang gano'n, di ba yung feeling na, parang dati kasi dahil nga hindi naman ako nag-apply, di ba? Opo. Di ba, tapos sinabi na lang, mag-report lang ako sa kanila. So, napaka-blessed na tao, di ba?
Correct,
so, dami naghahanap ng trabaho. So, and then, yung unang paycheck, actually, hindi naman siya paycheck kasi pay envelope siya.
Opo.
This is real, no? This is real. So, parang doon lang ako nagkaroon ng realization, nagtatrabaho na pala ako.
But in few months, so from April and then you shifted to the law firm.
The law firm.
Gano'n kayo katagal tumagal doon as a secretary?
Okay, kasi the offer, so parang August ata yun ako na sa law.
Opo.
Hindi ko na rin maalala yung talagang exact dates. No? But same year lang nangyari lahat eh. The offer, okay, I was recruited by my another best friend, BFF, classmate ko sa UST, Nenet. Okay. She recruited me. She invited me to apply. No, she invited me to apply. Sabi niya, sister, parang I don't really see you doing good para dyan. It's supposed to be where you are right now. No. Mm-hmm. So, I'm not happy kung nasaan ako. So, sabi ko sa kanya, well, anyway, sabi niya ganyan, okay, kindly apply, submit all your documents, and okay, so let's just see, sabi niya, okay. So, I also took the chance, nagpaalam din ako dun sa ninong kasin ko, no, na I would like to give it a try. Though alam ko namang may iba namang mga applicants doon. So, among our barkada in college, so, dalawa kami na nag-apply, parehas kaming may rose. Rosemarie ako, may rose siya. Parehas kami. But, isa lang kasi yung opening at the time, no? Kasi, ang kailangan noon sa student affairs was a substitute for one personnel who's going to have her doctorate study leave. Okay? Uh-huh. Parang substitute lang. So, and then that already started it all with my job with UP.
So, among the experiences that you have right now, as nandito na nga sa academe at the same time nagkakaroon ka ng deals with different type of people, ano yung pinaka-learnings naman?
Learnings, no? I-ano na natin, i-lump na natin yan. Mm-hmm. We need really to adjust ourselves to the situation. Learning is a continuous process, no? Okay? Everything, you know, all possibilities would have to be open to you. And one thing that you have to do is just embrace these possibilities as they happen. Okay? Kasi kung meron kang resistance, it makes it more harder and difficult on your part. So, remember that we cannot do away with assignments, of course, right? When you're already working, you'd be given tasks to do. And as an employee, you have, of course, to deliver and to comply. So, no matter how difficult this task would be, like additional assignments that would have to be given to you, let's just take this on a positive note. No? The trust is there that you can deliver. And that's something good. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You just take the positivity out of this additional concerns that you're having. Yan yung pinaka-learning ko as I went through. Okay.
So sabi nyo kanina na kailangan minsan yung sarili ko, ibagay ko sa environment. Kasi nagkakaroon ka rin ng adjustment kasi you need to accept the changes in your environment. Do you think ito yung nag-push sa inyo to pursue higher education?
Yes, practically. Okay, the pressure. Although, sabi ko nun, my children were two of my children na, yung two of my kids na, graduate na sila noon eh. Okay. Uh-huh. Naku kasi, although sabi nila noon, oh, you have to pursue the graduate studies na. Okay, habang bata ka pa, di ba? So ganon. So sabi ko, syempre, I would have to set priority, okay, for myself. And at the moment, what I felt then was the need for the education of our children, okay? So, inuna ko muna yung mga overload. Yung mm-hmm. overload, no? Until, nung nakita kong halos patapos na sila, sabi ko, siguro I should give time already for myself, okay? So, what I would like myself to have at the time, because given na, I have already fulfilled the mother role, okay? Kasi nakagraduate na sila from college, no? And my eldest was already doing mm-hmm. well in his work at the time too. My second was starting to have his, okay? So, ang naiwan na lang was my youngest. So, halos sabay kaming gumraduate nung bunso eh. Nung bunso, so sabay na lang. So, I was trying to have the balance, no? Mag-aaral ako ngayon, so may mga priorities ako na money, okay? For the education of the kids. So, sabi ko, nung kinalculate, kinestimate ko rin siya. So, kung ito mag-aaral ako ngayon, magkano ko ba yung gagastusin namin sa bunso? Yun yung mga considerations ko. But the other push that I had at the time was because also of the particular designation that I was given. Okay? Mm-hmm. All those given the designation, okay, that particular designation were doctors. Okay? So, syempre, andun yung pressure pa, especially when you attend meetings, okay? There will be the professional organizations, although not naman, of course, our doctors, but if they would have to be tracing back, you know, patang something din kasi na, I would also like to keep up, okay? Mm-hmm. The demands also of the designation.
Apo, ma'am. Since sinabi niyo yung designation niyo, priorities niyo, how do you keep the balance? Kasi, number one, daughter ka. Definitely, you still have your family, immediate family from your parents. Tapos, as a wife, hindi pa pwedeng medyo pera din si hubby. So, agad maaari talagang yung percentage niyo. And then, may anak kayo. At the same time, so sa workplace natin, nandiyan yung colleagues. Eh. So hindi pa pwedeng mawala yung colleagues and friends. So how do you keep the five balance for yourself, for your family, for your career, for your colleagues, and definitely for God?
Of course, the for God would always have to be the utmost priority, that we would always have to start and end the day with God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Our simple prayers alone, okay? So, mahirap talaga. It's really, really very difficult, no? Lalo na for a working mom.
Correct. Okay?
It's really a challenge for a working mom. Kung meron mang isang bagay, probably this would be the regret also that I would be having for myself because I did not really have, practically have the time, okay, to really have this full hand on my kids when they were growing up. So, but I was lucky because my mom is here, okay? My mom is here, okay? Although hindi din yun sana dapat, no? But we can't avoid because we are working moms.
So, correct.
Ito yung mga joys, di ba? Kung may joy, meron ding pains, di ba? Pains correct. Of being mom. That no matter how much you would like also to be involved in their growth, okay? May mga isa-sacrifice ka, no? Lalo na kung meron kang designation. Of course, there would be now the demands coming from your superiors, okay? There would even come a time that there would be activities with your kids at school that you also have yung mga same day activity also that you'd have to attend to. No? So, weigh mo yan. And kung sakali mang pwede kang magpaalam sa work, no? Pwede magpaalam and have a substitute. So that would be one way that I would be doing, okay? But as much as possible, of course, kung ako rin naman na mag-i-schedule, like if there, it would be an activity that we would be having for the university, and I would be the one to schedule. So kung kaya ko namang ma-foresee na agad kung ano yung mga activities na yan, so syempre, fini-free ko yon. Okay, fini-free ko yon. There was even a time that when I had a Saturday, no, because we were engaged with foreign students. So yung bunso ko, kasama ko yon. Pinasama ko na siya sa mga kung saan man kami nandoon para at least, kaya lang yung dalawa, syempre, yung dalawang anak ko pa, hindi ko na sila natututuhan. But I'm really blessed and proud of how my boys are. Okay, lalo na boys sila, no?
Uh-huh.
Although meron namang mga slight na mga concerns, like na late lang sila sa school, no? But not really that big issues that I encountered with my kids, their school, okay? Na kahit lalaki, di ba, usually pag lalaki, connotation. So, and okay sila, no? I'm really proud. I would have to brag about my three boys, Julius, Carl, and syempre, hindi naman perfect, no? Wala rin din naman perfect lahat. But I know that I'm really proud of how they have become, okay? Na surpass nila yon.
Nakikita rin kasi nila as a model, definitely, as a mom. How do you maintain? So, for the family also. Normally, yung tao, once they reach the top, they normally tends to chill or to relax. To engage in some of their, sabihin natin, me time. So, nandoon na yung kanilang leisure time. So, yes. Ano ba yung next na inaasahan namin sa inyo? Kasi you're already a doctor, you finished the PhD, you're having your good time now because most of your kids are already, sabihin natin, successful na rin. At the same time, dun sa career nyo, so fulfilling na rin yung status nyo right now. So, ano ba yung next na niluluto ni Doc Marie?
Yeah, you already mentioned it. The next step for Doc Marie, actually, I'm not really used being called Doc Marie. No, parang ano pa rin, no? Anyway, the next step for me is, as you have said, is for the me time. For the me time. At the moment, sabi mo nga, parang para sa akin kasi, I know that I already had done my part for the university, right? So I was not actually looking forward to any designation already, right? Parang I have been through it all. Name it, I've been through it all, okay? So it's a secret that I would have to be sharing. We got married early, so mm-hmm. we were into a very early responsibility. So I believe both my husband and I, Moni and I, deserve it now to be enjoying life, okay? Kaya nga, kaya sabi ko sa sarili ko, it's now the time for the me time, okay? Enjoying, okay? So, probably ang sineset ko ngayon is at 60, okay? Mm-hmm. So that's several years from now. So I'll have my early retirement.
How about writing your biography or a book in future?
But that could be something that I could look forward to, Doc Ronnie.
We will pray for that.
Yeah. I would have that in mind. Okay, I would take that suggestion that you have for me, Doc Ronnie, Doc Anna.
We will support that, ma'am. Okay po. So, in this interview, meron akong fanfare picture. Saan yung, naalala niyo po ko saan ito?
Sa Baguio ba yun? Hindi ko na maalala. Basta last time yan, no? Yun ang problema ko ngayon, to recall yung mga specific names, no?
Mm-hmm. So, maganda mo magawa kayo diary.
Oo nga, yun. Pero nag-ano kami yan, nag-grape picking kami yan. Baguio ata yung pinuntahan namin noon eh, or somewhere near Baguio, okay?
Yeah. So this is one of the school activities na pinuntahan nyo?
Because I'm a member of the senior PWD group. So part mm-hmm. of exploration ng mga, yung sa activity nila for the year. So for engagement of senior, for entrepreneurial suggestions nila. So we visited different places, no? And ito yung on the side, so we had this grape picking, okay?
Mm-hmm. So actually nagkaroon din po ba ng development, kasi personal development din yung parang field trip, so
field trip ng matatanda na. Okay, we have the group senior. Of course I don't belong with the senior, but I'm with the PWD group.
Opo, so thank you so much, ma'am. Mm-hmm. And how about this one? Actually, may kulang pa ata si Ma'am Estupigan before she's part of the because I'm an OSA
family.
OSA baby actually yung tawag nila kasi
OSA baby.
Opo, kasi third year I joined the scholarship from CHED. So third year ako nag-start. So nandiyan pa nga dapat si Ma'am Estupigan. So can you name them, Ma'am, from our left side?
Left. Of course we have Ma'am Meg.
Okay. Opo.
Ma'am, Ate Emma.
Okay. Opo.
Ate Meg. Okay, pala. Kasi friends pala. Ate Meg, Ate Emma. Of course, that's me. Okay. Having that smile. Signature smile daw yan eh. Okay. Then we have Ate...
Lilia.
Lilia. Okay. We have Jaja. And of course...
Ako. Okay. Wala si Mama Stabit. Actually, Mami, si... Doc Aquino, si Ma'am Meg, kasi before entering the college, actually ma'am, yung kwento ko kasi sa PUP, I started sa PNU. So sa PNU ako nag-inquire. Mm-hmm. That was May na. So yun na yung pera ko talaga na natitira sa PNU. And then that time, sarado na yung mm-hmm. exam for PNU. Actually ang PUP, hindi ko talaga siya ma'am totally alam. So, nung nag-aral ako ng high school, kasi may mga intern na teacher sa PNU sila. So, PNU, tsaka gusto ko talaga yung madali lang. Kasi 300 that time lang yung tuition fee sa PNU. So, sabi niya, Ronnie, magaling ka naman sa math. Try mo PNU. It happens na nag-ipon muna kami kasi hindi naman nga kami ganun kayaman. Hindi ko alam ang TUP, ma'am. So, I asked the girls sa PNU and then sinabi na wala ng exam. So, ano na ako, luhaan na ako na umuwi. So, I only have money for my transportation from Manila to TU, to my house in Las Piñas. And then I saw a student, I think that was 3 or 4 o'clock p.m. already. I saw a student, nakalagay yung TUP logo, yung gear ng TUP. And then I read them, parang organizational church, organization t-shirt ata. So nabasa ko, Technological University of the Philippines. And then I saw students coming by. Kasi tatawid ako from PNU, tatawid ako sa kabilang side eh. Papuntang Luneta. And then I followed them. So sa gate 1, I saw Technological University of the Philippines. And then I asked the guard, ano yung school na to? Ano yung meron dyan? Sabi niya, then I asked, sabi, ano po ba yung, meron pa ba bang entrance exam? So sabi niya, last na, I think that was Thursday. Thursday yun, ma'am, if I can. And then, ang exam nun, linggo. Saturday or Sunday, yung weekend ng exam. And then sabi niya, paano po ba yung process? I only have that much money, is only 75 pesos.
Oh.
So that was the registration fee for the exam, if I recall that time. So kailangan yung process, may aptitude interview muna. So dalawa yung professor nun, si, I think Dr. Lomotan was that time, kung na, I'm not sure ma'am, basta, kasi wala na rin si Dr. Lomotan after that time. And then si Ma'am Meg, dalawa sila nag-i-interview. So, pumila ako. So, I have my papers kasi mag-apply ako sa PNU. So, the same lang naman yung requirements. Picture, etc. Yung mga pipilapan, yung high school card. So, bit-bit ko yun. So, kailangan dalawa, may interview muna. So, yung interview, lahat ng ini-interview nung isa nag-i-interview, parang baksak daw. Yung parang mahigpit kasi si Ma'am. So, I keep on praying. Sana kay Doc Meg ako mapunta. So I came and prayed. So sabi niya, kay Doc Meg, para okay yung interview dun sa isang prof daw. Kasi parang lahat naman ng tanong, practical, nasasagot naman nila. I keep on praying that. So fortunately, nadinggin naman yung panalangin ko. So from that time, nakilala ko si Doc Meg. So si Ma'am Meg yung nag-interview sa akin. So hindi ko makakalimutan yun. So in-interview niya ako. And then actually, ang pinipili ko lang na course is just only mathematics teacher for education. And then she suggested me, okay naman yung grades mo ng science, ng English, ng math, why don't you go for engineering? Kasi may slot pa. Kasi ano ka na eh, final, hindi naman waiting list eh, parang kami yung last batch. So malaki yung opportunity mo or yung chance mo to go for the engineering. She suggested me that time. Pero wala ko alam ng idea sa engineering. Honestly, pag sinabi kasi engineer, civil engineer lang yung nag-wear ng hard hat. That is the only thing na alam ko for the engineer kasi alam ko kasi hindi ako magka-college. So sabi niya, itong time na to, generation that time, electronics and communication pa, electronics and communication engineering is booming. Why don't you go try this? So dun sa aptitude interview, so tinulungan ako ni Ma'am Meg. So yun yung in-applyan ko. So that is the history. So after that history ang nangyari. So that's why I'm so grateful with Doc Meg. Every time na kinukwento ko kay Ma'am Meg, nakakalimutan ko na ata yun. So parang hindi ko ata maalala yun. So si Doc Meg yung nag-start sa akin. And then, habang nag-aral ako nung college, so galing nga kami sa mahirap din, hindi rin masustain yung pamasahe ko, etc. So hindi ko alam na yung grades ko pala ay pa-pwede for scholarship. And then I bump you second year college. Nagtuturo kayo ng Philippines Constitution sa amin. And then, there is some Makati Scholar students na they call you as you're as nanay because kayo nga yung SM Scholar, yung mga Makati boys, sila yung SM Scholar. So I inquired then. I think kailangan first year, kailangan scholar ka na. And then I asked you, ma'am, is there a scholarship after nung second year? Kasi maganda naman yung grades ko. Nung nadidins list kahit pa paano. So, napapost pa nga sa registrar. And then, sabi mo sa akin, try mo kasi maganda yung grades mo. So, hindi kayo nagkaroon ng hesitation, ng doubtfulness sa akin. So, you supported me. Dilatag nyo immediately. Sabi, may anak. Yun yung unang tawag niya sa akin. Kasi, naging teacher ko kayo pero hindi pa tayo ganun ka-close. So, anak, try mo to. So, doon ako nagkaroon ng tawag, acceptance yung magkaroon ng assurance na continue kasi mag-stop na talaga ako noong time na yun. So nakita ko yung requirements, I maintain. So immediately after you gave me the application form, so si Ma'am Emma, you also helped me. Even si Ma'am Abe Benica, siya pa yung OSA director noon. Then si Ma'am Janet, si Ma'am Estupigan. So every time I visited you every end of the SEM, you keep on congratulating me. Oh, anak, may scholar, may allowance ka na. So you will get your go to land bank sa Ortigas pa ata, sa Pasig. Sa Pasig pa. Ano yun eh? Cheque pa. Papalitan namin sa land bank. So, I'm so grateful and thankful sa tropa nyo, ma'am. Sa inyong grupo. Kasi hindi kayo naging madamot, number one. To us as students like me, you are support. How about this? Can you remember? Ano pa pwedeng ma-share nyo na picture, ma'am?
I gave you that bracelet.
Yeah, I still have it. I actually, you gave me this one before leaving the Philippines. So matagal, actually, ma'am, nung final defense ko sa dissertation, I used this also. So pagka mayroon akong nararamdaman na problema sa katawan, kahit kasi sa ibang bansa, kahit naman may health insurance ka, so iba pa rin yung sa Pilipinas ka magpa-check o magpa-doctor. So every time na magkakaroon ako, it helps actually. It's, I think, medyo ano siya, miraculous friend. So it helps so much. Yeah, talaga, ang laki ng tulong sa akin nung binigay niyo na bracelet na yun.
I'm a devotee of Padre Pio, Saint Padre Pio, and me and my family have been receiving a lot of these blessings. So every time that I would have my friends along, no, parang iba rin kasi yung feeling ko, like when I buy these bracelets too, at times I don't really understand. May mga beses kasi na that bracelet is supposed to be for somebody else, no, but somebody comes along and then there would be some a whisper that I would be having or asking me that to give that to the person, no? It could be the stampita or
ano. I still have the stampita, ma'am.
Every time that I would have to hear about my friends, about what they are having through, no? It's okay, magta-travel sila. So, ito yung lagi kong pabaon. Ang pabaon ko would always be my prayers. And of course, I would have to be having Padre Pio around. Okay?
Yes. So, ano po ba yung number one message nyo muna kay Mother?
Of course, my mom is already 82. And ang wish niya kasi lagi is to reach 100 plus years old.
We will pray for it, ma'am. We will pray for it.
100 plus years old, no? So, would have to be going with the wish that she stays healthy and she would have that wish come true, okay? And to enjoy the life that she would be having. Ang ano lang namin kasi ngayon is to, may nakalimutan pala ako na ano, what's up for Dr. Marie. Okay? Uh-huh. And that would be also that my mom would also be looking forward to is for us to have our grandchildren. But, that would come. I know that would come. That would come. No? So, my mom has looked forward for having the grand apos na. Okay, apos na. Mm-hmm.
Doc Marie, any final word and message to our viewers?
Okay, so thank you for this opportunity to be sharing my insights and thoughts for making me what I am right now, okay? So, no matter what life brings you, where it leads you, please do always remember that we have a choice to make things happen and matter. Life is how we make it. You are the director of your own life stories. Our life choices matters. So thank you for the opportunity.
Okay, ma'am. So before I wrap up our interview, meron lang akong 2 or 3 fast talk. So nakapag-travel na naman namin kayo, ma'am. So you've been to several countries. Ano yung pinaka top 3 na favorite nyong country na napuntahan?
Top 3? Tama, tatlo lang sila. tatlo pa lang naman. Okay. Siyempre, siguro arrange ko na lang yung order ng priority. Tatlo lang sila. Of course, the number one would always be the United States because we have family in the United States, especially now that my second is in the US. Okay. And then next would have to be, the next one is Singapore.
Mm-hmm.
Apat na pala. Okay. Singapore and then Korea would be next. Okay. List na yung Thailand.
okay po. So, kanina na-mention nyo dun sa conversation natin yung me time for your next chapter. Ano ba yung favorite gawin ni Doc Marie during her leisure time?
God, ngayon, kasi naiiba eh. Naiiba yung mga favorite time ko eh. Pero hindi naman na favorite time ko ang pagkain. Alam mo yan. Alam mo yan, ang pagkain, no? Kaya, nung pandemic nga, I was trying to discover my cooking skills, right? Pero ngayon, the me time that I have, okay, it's funny, no? Kaya nga, me time, no? It's watching Korean novela.
Mama, yung pinaka-favorite niya na napanood na?
Ako, hindi pwede kasing favorite, eh. Lahat sila favorite.
Okay, ma'am. Sino yung favorite actor nyo na hindi nyo makakalimutan sa mga napanood nyo? Definitely meron kayong i-check sa internet nyan.
Can I have 2?
O, sige po.
Of course. Can I have three? Can I have three? Although I have watched a lot of Korean novelas. Of course, the third one would have to be Lee Min Ho.
Lee Min Ho, po.
Third yun, ha? A second would be, what's this? Yoon Bin.
Yoon Bin, okay.
Actually, Yoon Bin and the first one would have to be in the same rank, eh.
Mm-hmm.
Because, pero ang una ko kasi yung naging favorite, because yun yung una kong napanood, is Kim Soo Yoon. Although I had the one, meron din na una, pero kasi dahil yung kanilang telenovela, yung I'm Okay Not to Be Okay, was really timely last year. And I had related a lot of things, especially na-incorporate ko rin sa mga talks ko yung mga natutunan. Remember the butterfly hug? Yeah, I got it there. So, parang, saka siya yung tumilim sa akin. Although, kaya sinabi ko sa'yo, parang balansi naman si Yoon Bin. At alam naman niya ng asawa ko.
So, thank you so much for sharing your answer, Doc Marie. Shout out po before we close our interview. Shout out for your loved ones, your friends, your colleagues, to everyone.
Of course, we just celebrated our 36th anniversary. The first shout out would be to my husband, Edmond. Pa, okay? We made it to our 36th, and hopefully, looking forward to our golden. Okay. Of course, to my mom. Okay. Mommy. Okay. Pag napanood mo to, so, bida ka rin dito. May picture ka dito. And to my three sons, in the order of birth rank.
Mm-hmm. Walang favoritism.
In the order of birth rank, we have Julius Anthony. We have Christian Carl and Vince Kenneth. Okay, so my family. Now, mahirap kasi pa yung kung pangalan. So, shout out to my, of course, to my registrar family right now. Okay? Pabalik tayo pagdating sa family, sa career. Registrar family. Then we have the HR family. We have the OSO family. And of course, as a whole, we have the TUP family. Marami pa. To my friends out there na hindi ko man kayo mabati isa-isa. OSO babies.
Correct.
To the awesome babies, okay, you complete our fulfillment, okay? You are our non-blood children, but we are happy, okay, to where you are right now. You just don't know how we feel good about your accomplishments, okay? Kasi anak nga namin kayo, no? Yung anak na yan, yung anak na tawag natin. At iba talaga pag awesome baby. Ibang klase ang dating pag-osa baby. Shout out to my relatives, of course, to everyone. They have made my 55 years of existence, okay, a blessing, truly a blessing. Okay, you are all a blessing. Thank you for giving me this blessed life. Okay. So I guess that would be all, Doc Ronnie.
Okay, thank you so much for accepting this interview. I would like to share what I learned from this conversation. So from the introduction up to this conclusion part, change is very difficult. Having change in our life is not that easy, but having change in our life is very essential. So thank you so much for watching this episode.